press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hi everyone. So in this part we are going to start new lesson, metals and non-metals. So before going the metals and non-metals, so have you seen, you haven't heard the materials, so which are you are using in your daily life, like nickel, cobalt, iron, hydrogen, oxygen. So these names you are already heard in your life, okay? So it means, so these materials we will call it as the elements. So this elements, what are these elements? So this iron, copper, nickel, cobalt, so what I told, so these are called as elements. Means, so these the substances which cannot broken down into simple substances, okay? So for them we will call it as the elements. So this iron means, for example, I am taking iron. So iron, so we are only iron we are giving a chemical reaction, means it will not broken up into simple substance, okay? So it consists of only one iron atom, so there is no other atoms in that iron element. So means, if we are taking iron element, iron atom means, so in that iron atom there are only iron atoms will be present. Means in further, so in atom, so we are dividing that in the structure of atom, means it consists of protons, electrons and neutrons. So in the higher classes you have come to know about that. So like that, so one atom means it only consists of the particular element, okay? So they, it will not mix with the other atoms. We are taking the iron means, so it consists of iron only, iron, it consists of iron atoms only. So we cannot say that the hydrogen atoms are there, oxygen atoms are there, okay? So for these, like these materials we will called as a elements. So after knowing that elements, so these elements are divided into two types. So for those are called as metals and non-metals, okay? So this elements means the substances, elements means the substance which cannot broken into simple substances. It cannot broken into simple substances by chemical reaction. Okay, so number of elements I told that it may be iron, it may be copper, it may be nickel. So these elements we are representing in the symbol. Okay, so these elements will not broken up into simple substances on chemical reaction. If I am taking the iron, so it, this whole element is consist of only iron atoms, okay? So there is no hydrogen, or it may be copper, it may be nickel, okay? So there are other atoms will not present in that iron atoms. If I am taking iron element, so it should contain the, it will contain only iron atoms. For those we will call it as elements. So these elements are divided into two parts, so that is metals and non-metals. So I told that, so here I mentioned the three elements, but we are having 180 elements, okay? Totally we are having the 110 elements. So in higher classes you will come to know about what are those elements, how are the arranged in, okay? So these elements are divided into metals and non-metals. So in this chapter we are going to discuss about the properties of metals and non-metals. So by seeing their properties, we will say that which element will come under the metals. So which element shows those properties of means elements. So which elements will shows the metal properties and which element shows the non-metal properties. By seeing that, we are making that group, the separate elements are in the periodic table. Okay. So these 118 elements are arranged in the periodic table. Okay. So these this periodic table was made by Mendeleev, scientist called Mendeleev. He made all the elements in one table according to their atomic number. So like that, he is denoting that as symbol with their names, like that all the information we can get in that periodic table. So this periodic table also we came to learn in the higher classes. So now we will discuss about the physical properties and chemical properties of metals and non-metals both. Okay. So first we will discuss the physical properties of metals. Physical properties of metals. So what are the physical properties of metals? One by one we will discuss. So metals are malleable, means for example, I told you, so take pieces of aluminium, iron and gold, silver, like this different materials. Okay, so check that which we will break down, which we will beat, means when we will beat them, broken them, so they will made into thin sheets. Okay, so yavudanna navu thin sheets aagi maadabodu anta. So those elements we will call it as metals. So those will choose the malleable character, means it is a property. The property of a metal, property of metal which can be broken down into, which can be broken down and made a thin sheets. So copper, iron, so we are denoting iron as Fe, copper, so symbolically we are denoting the copper as Cu. Okay, so this is the one property of the metals. Second one is, metals are ductile. So ductile means it is also the property of a metal. Property of a metal which can be drawn into wires. So some materials we can draw in them into wires. So means thin wires. So example, it may be silver, gold. So like this, we are seeing the ductile property in the metals. Okay, so these metals are malleable. So this metal, it is a property of a metal which can be broken down and made a thin sheets. Okay, so for example, iron and copper. Then other metals are ductile. So the property of a metal which can be drawn into thin wires. So these are the two properties of metals. So the next one is, so metals are poor conductors of heat and electricity. So for this we can check that, so which are the elements which can allow the electricity to pass them. Okay, so for example, to check the electricity, what we will do, so for one cell we will hold, so in that we are in both the sides we are applying, we are joining the wire. So in the middle, which can, so we want to put the one material, means for example it may be iron nail. So it may be gold, it may be iron nail, it may be copper, okay. So just check them, okay, which will pass through them, okay. So they will allow the electricity or not. So these metals, so which are iron, copper, silver, gold, so these metals will allow the electricity to pass through them, okay. So which materials will allow the electricity to pass through them? So those materials we will call it as metals. So fourth one is, metals are lustrous means the elements which having the surface shining, okay. So these gold, copper, iron, the silver, these are showing the very shiny surfaces. They are having the very shiny surfaces. That's why this gold and silver are making for ornaments and jewelries. They are very, very attractive. So the metal shows the character property of lustrous. Then metals are sonorous. So what does this sonorous means? Sound. Okay, so the metals which produces the sound are beating. So for example, in your schools or it may be in your home, so vessels made up of steel, made up of silver, so made up of iron, aluminium, they will all produce the sound when we will beat, okay. So those materials which produces the sound and beating, so that property we will call as sonorous. They will shows the metal physical property called sonorous, okay. So sixth one is, metals are very hard and strong. So can we bend the iron or silver like that old as usually? So we cannot bend them very easily, okay. They are very strong and hard, okay. They will not cut with the knife, okay. They will not cut with the knife. We want to cut means we want to heat them, okay. So like that materials will come under metals. Seventh one is, metals have high melting point and boiling point. Melting point and boiling point. Okay, so these have the, so this is the good conductors of heat and electricity. So the which allows the electricity. So for them we will call it as good conductors of electricity and heat. So this seventh one is, metals have high melting point and boiling point. Okay, so this initially I told that they are very hard and strong. So means they are very hard and strong means we want to bend them. So mean the, we want give the high heat. So high, they are also, they contain the high melting point and boiling point. Okay, so these are the properties of metals. And these metals are only solids. So all the metals are in solid. Metals are solids except mercury. Okay, except mercury, all the metals are in solid state. Okay, so these are the physical properties of metals. So metals will shows the malleability, metal will shows the ductility, and the metals are very good conductors of electricity and heat, means they will allow the electricity and heat to pass through them, okay. So then metals are lustrous means shiny. So these metals have a shiny surfaces, okay. So then metals are sonorous means they will produce the sound, okay. So for them we will call it as sonorous. Then metals are very hard and strong. So they are very hard and strong. We cannot cut with the knife. So to beat them, we have to use the high boiling point and melting point. So the last one is, metals are solid except mercury. All the metals are in solid state, but except mercury. Okay. So by saying this, we can say that which are the elements will come under the metals. Okay. So now we will see the physical properties of the non-metals. So these non-metals will shows opposite to character of metals. Okay. So all these physical properties of metals are that opposite to the non-metals. Physical properties of non-metals. Okay, so the firstly what we discussed in the metals, so they are opposite. Okay, so non-metals are not malleable. Okay, they will not show the malleability. Means, so for example, it may be oxygen, carbon, and this one, carbon, oxygen, then helium, hydrogen, sulfur, helium, hydrogen, sulfur. So these are all non-metals. Okay. So these are all non-metals which are not malleable. Means these hydrogen, sulfur, helium, we cannot beaten up and made them into thin sheets. Okay. So second one is, so non-metals are not, non-metals are not ductile. So what does mean this means ductile? So I told that in metals, so it is a property which shows that metals can drawn into thin wires. So these oxygen, carbon and helium, hydrogen, sulfur, we cannot drawn them into thin wires. Okay, they are not ductile. Third one is, they have bad conductor of, means very poor conductor of heat and electricity. So they not allow the electricity or heat to pass through them. Okay, they are very very bad conductors, but in the non-metals they are very good conductors of heat and electricity. And the fourth one is, they are not lustrous. Okay, they will not, they are not having the shiny surfaces. And non-metals are not sonorous. They will also not produce the sound on beating. Okay, so then sixth one is, non-metals are not sonorous and non-metals are very soft, but metals are very hard and strong. So these non-metals we can cut with the knife. Okay, so they like that, they are most soft non-metals. So the seventh one is, so as I told that metals are in only solid state, but these non-metals are in solid also, liquid also, and gas. Okay, but in metals, so only mercury is in liquid, all the metals are in solid state, but here in the non-metals, solid, liquid and gas, all the states will be present, and the elements will be all present in the solid state also, liquid state also, and gas. Okay, so these are the properties of non-metals, and non-metals have low boiling point and melting point. So, ಸೊ ಇದನ್ನ ನೋಡಿದ್ರೆ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಆಪೋಸಿಟ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಅಲ್ವಾ ನಾನ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ. ಸೊ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೇ ದ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ನಾನ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ಮಧ್ಯೆ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೈಟ್ ಇಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ನಾನ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಮ್ಯಾಲಿಯಬಲ್, ನಾನ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಡಕ್ಟೈಲ್. ಸೊ ಹಾಗೆ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಕಾಂಪೌಂಡ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಯಾವ್ದಾದ್ರು ನಾವು ಥಿನ್ ಆಗಿ ಇರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಶೀಟ್ಸನ್ನು ಏನಾದರೂ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದೀವ ಅಥವಾ ಥಿನ್ ವೈರ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಏನಾದರೂ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದೀವ? ನೋ. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ವಿ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ದ ಸಲ್ಫರ್, ಕಾರ್ಬನ್, ಹೀಲಿಯಮ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್. ದಿಸ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಯು ಹರ್ಡ್ ದಟ್ ದೀಸ್ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದೋಸ್? ನೋ, ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿ ನೋ. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ವೆರಿ ಬ್ಯಾಡ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟರ್, ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅಲೋ ದ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿ ಯು ಪಾಸ್ ಥ್ರೂ ದೆಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಲಸ್ಟರಸ್, ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದ ಶೈನಿ ಸರ್ಫೇಸಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸಿಲ್ವರ್. ಸೊ ನಾನ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸೋನರಸ್. ಸೊ ಲೈಕ್ ಸಿಲ್ವರ್, ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟೀಲ್, ಕಾಪರ್, ಐರನ್, ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸಸ್ ದ ಸೌಂಡ್. ಬಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಸಲ್ಫರ್, ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್, ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಆರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್, ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಗ್ಯಾಸಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿಸ್ ಹೀಲಿಯಮ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ದ ಸೌಂಡ್. ದೆನ್ ನಾನ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ವೆರಿ ಸಾಫ್ಟ್ ಬಟ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ವೆರಿ ಹಾರ್ಡ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದ ಲೋ ಮೆಲ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬಾಯ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್. ಸೊ ನಾನ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸಮ್ ನಾನ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ಸಾಲಿಡ್, ಸಮ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ಲಿಕ್ವಿಡ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸಮ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಗ್ಯಾಸಸ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ವಿ ಸಿ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್, ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಫಿಸಿಕಲ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ನಾನ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ನಾವು ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟೀಸ್. ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನಾನ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಬೋತ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಸಿ. ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನಾನ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನಾನ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್? ಸೊ ಫಸ್ಟ್ಲಿ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಸಿ ದಟ್ ಹೌ ದ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನಾನ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ವಾಟರ್, ಆ್ಯಸಿಡ್, ಬೇಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಸಿ ದಟ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನಾನ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್. ಓಕೆ, ವಿತ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಮೆಗ್ನೀಷಿಯಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಎ ಮೆಟಲ್. ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ದ ಮೆಗ್ನೀಷಿಯಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಬರ್ನ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್, ವಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್? ದಟ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮೆಗ್ನೀಷಿಯಮ್ ಆಕ್ಸೈಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ವೆನ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್, ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ ಆಕ್ಸೈಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಜನರಲ್ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ಫಾರ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಮೆಟಲ್ ವೆನ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಗಿವ್ ದ ಮೆಟಲ್ ಆಕ್ಸೈಡ್. ಸೊ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಮೆಗ್ನೀಷಿಯಮ್. ವೆನ್ ಮೆಗ್ನೀಷಿಯಮ್ ವಿಲ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗಿವ್ಸ್ ದ ಮೆಗ್ನೀಷಿಯಮ್ ಆಕ್ಸೈಡ್. ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ಮೆಗ್ನೀಷಿಯಮ್ ಆಕ್ಸೈಡ್ ಡಿಸೋಲ್ವ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ವಾಟರ್, so it will produce magnesium hydroxide. So 2 magnesium oxide plus H2O will gives magnesium hydroxide. Okay, so we will call it as magnesium hydroxide. So like this, metal when reacts with oxygen, they will give metal oxide, and when it dissolves in water, so it gives magnesium hydroxide. So when we want to check that, so these metals are in acidic nature or a basic nature. Okay, so to check this, we want to make that. So first magnesium hydroxide we are obtaining. So when we will react the magnesium hydroxide with red litmus paper. Okay, so the red litmus paper will be there. So for by using that, we can say we can conclude that so metal which metal will produce shows the acidic nature and basic nature. Okay, so this magnesium hydroxide turns red litmus to blue. So it will turns the red litmus to blue paper. So red litmus paper na blue aagi convert madutte. Blue color. So blue color torsutte. So now en helbodu hagadre, which shows that magnesium oxide is the basic in nature. So this is a basic oxide. It shows that these metals are basic in nature. Okay, so from to check this again, we can say that iron rust agiruttala. So rust agiruttakanta powder na, so ondu test tube alli navu tagondve antandre tagondittu adakke swalpa water hakbeku. So water haaki adana heat madlikke swalpa to heat madlikke ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಹೀಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ಬಿಟ್ಟು ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಆ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ನ ತೊಗೊಂಡು ಬೇರೆ ಒಂದು ಬಿಕ್ಕರಲ್ಲಿ ತೊಗೊಂಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಅದ್ರ ಒಳಗಡೆ ಈ ರೆಡ್ ಲಿಟ್ಮಸ್ ಪೇಪರ್ನ ಇಟ್ಟು ನೋಡಿದ್ರೆ ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ರೆಡ್ ಲಿಟ್ಮಸ್ ಪೇಪರ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಬ್ಲೂ. ಓಕೆ, ಇನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಟೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಬುಕ್ ದಟ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಆರ್ ಶೋನ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ರೆಡ್ ಲಿಟ್ಮಸ್ ಪೇಪರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಟು ಬ್ಲೂ ಕಲರ್. ಸೊ ಬೈ ದಿಸ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೇ ದಟ್ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೀಷಿಯಮ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಶೋಸ್ ದ basic nature. So okay, so for that rusting of iron I told, for like that copper also, rusting of iron, when we collect the powder of rusting of iron, so by that we can say that also, so the this basic nature we can check that, and through the copper also. So when the copper they will contact with oxygen, means they will mix with they will contact with air and water, so they will turn into greenish layer. Okay, so that sample also we can take, means from that also we can say that so this metals will shows the basic nature. So rusting of iron, 3Fe plus O2 plus H2O, so gives us Fe2O3, iron oxide, rusting of iron. Okay, so from these reactions, so we can say that so metals are basic in nature. So when metals react with oxygen, they will form the metal oxide, and then when we dissolve the metal oxide in water, so it gives magnesium hydroxide. So this magnesium hydroxide, we can check that the metals are basic in nature or acidic in nature. We are taking this magnesium hydroxide and we are dipping the red litmus paper into inside that magnesium hydroxide solution. So it turns the red litmus paper into blue. Okay, like that similarly it is in case of rusting of iron also. So the iron, when we are putting the iron materials like some benches, some rods like that, we are outside for many years ago, it get rusted, it will change this. Why? Because it will come contact with the oxygen and water, it get rusting, it will start to rusting. Okay, so this rusting also will shows that so they are in basic nature. Okay, then what are the happens in the metals, but in the non-metals. So when non-metals reacts with oxygen, what happens? We will see. Okay. So for non-metals, I am taking here sulfur. Okay. So first one alle, so oxygen gene. So illi non-metals na tagondidini. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ನಾವು ನೋಡಿದ್ದು ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು ಸಲ್ಫರ್ ತಗೊಂಡು, ವೆನ್ ಸಲ್ಫರ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸಸ್ ಸಲ್ಫರ್ ಡೈಆಕ್ಸೈಡ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಸಲ್ಫರ್ ಡೈಆಕ್ಸೈಡ್ ವೆನ್ ವಿಸ್ ಡಿಸಾಲ್ವ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ವಾಟರ್, ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸಸ್ H2SO3. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಸಲ್ಫರ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್, so it will produce sulfur dioxide, and when sulfur dioxide dissolves in water, so it produces sulfurous acid. This is sulfurous acid, this is sulfur dioxide. So in similar, what will be done in the magnesium? So in the metals, like that also, like that only we are doing in this non-metal. So this is a sulfur. When sulfur react with oxygen, so it will produce us sulfur dioxide. Then when we will dissolve the sulfur dioxide in in water, so it produces sulfurous acid. So when we are checking that non-metal will shows the acidic or basic nature. So when we are taking the sulfurous acid, and the sulfurous acid turns blue litmus into red. Okay, so here blue litmus paper turns into red. Okay, so this will shows that this non-metals are in acidic in nature. Okay, so this is the reaction of non-metals with oxygen. So as in metals, we took the magnesium metal. So when magnesium metal will reacts with oxygen, it will form magnesium oxide. So like that only here we are taking the non-metal sulfur. So when sulfur reacts with oxygen, it forms sulfur dioxide, and this sulfur dioxide will dissolve in water. It gives sulfurous acid. But when we want to check the acidic or basic nature of the non-metals, means so we are using the blue litmus paper, and so it turns the blue litmus paper into red. So from this we can say that non-metals are in acidic in nature. Okay, so this is about the reaction of metals and non-metals with oxygen. So next we will see the reaction of metals and non-metals with water. Okay, with water. So hagadre metals hege react agutte water jothe non-metals hege react agutte. So metals alli enagutte, like sodium, so it is very very highly reactive metal, highly reactive. So when it will contact with water, means hydrogen and oxygen, it will get burned. So fire catch agutte idakke. So yavaga adana nav enadru sodium metal anna nav enadru gaalige bitre, so it will catches the fire. That's why it will stored in the sand athwa idralli bere separate aagi idana kerosene alli store maadirtare. Okay, so it will not when it will reacts with oxygen or in the water, so it will catches fire. So neevu sodium metal anna tagoli cut maadkoli. So this is very soft, so idan cut maadabodu. So cut maadi adana dry maadi by using filter paper. So dry maadid mele one beaker alli haaki adakke water haaki nodi. So it will suddenly catches the fire. It is very very highly reactive. So we can say that some metals like iron, so it will reacts slowly. Iron en madutte thumba nidanagagi react agutte, but sodium enagutte thumba bega react aagibittu fire catch agutte. So nimma textbook alli torisidare hege adu sodium react agutte anta anbittu. Okay, some metals will react vigorously with water, some metals will react with slowly. Okay, so like this. Then non metals so then what will the non metals what will do non metals so non metals like they will not react with water, so may be very reactive in air. For example, phosphorus. So phosphorus is very very reactive non-metal. It catches fire, that's why it's stored in the water. So idu nail ittirtare water alli store maadirtare. ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಅಟ್ಮಾಸ್ಫಿಯರಿಕ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ಗೆ ಇದು ಏನಾದರೂ ಕಾಂಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆಯಿತು ಅಂದರೆ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕ್ಯಾಪ್ಚರ್ಸ್ ಫೈರ್. So it should not contact with the atmospheric oxygen. So this non-metals are reaction with water is very very complex, means non-metals will not react with the water, but like non-metals like sulfur, they will highly react to the atmospheric oxygen. Non-metals do not react with water. ಓಕೆ, ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಯು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್ ದಟ್? ಸೊ ಹೇಗೆ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ಮತ್ತು ನಾನ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ಹೇಗೆ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ವಾಟರಲ್ಲಿ ಅಂತಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು, ಸೊ ಲೈಕ್ ಸೋಡಿಯಂ, ಸಮ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಸೋಡಿಯಂ ವಿತ್ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಹೈಲಿ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟಿವ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ವಾಟರ್, ಬಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಐರನ್, ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ವೆರಿ ಸ್ಲೋಲಿ. ಬಟ್ ಸಮ್ ನಾನ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಫೋಸ್ಫರಸ್, ದೇ ಆರ್ ವೆರಿ ಹೈಲಿ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟಿವ್ ವಿತ್ ವಾಟರ್, ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಟೋರ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ they will react with atmospheric oxygen very vigorously. Okay, so that's why they are stored in the water. So non-metals do not, the other non-metals will not react with the water. Okay, this is all about the reaction of metals and non-metals with water. So next, so how the non-metals and metals react with acid? So how they will react with the acid, we will see. Acid, so metals alli enagutte antandre magnesium matte kelavondu hydrochloric acid jothe react adre kelavondu sulfuric acid alli maatra react agutte. So magnesium plus 2HCl, so they will form the salt plus hydrogen gas. So this magnesium chloride as a salt, so this is hydrogen gas. Okay, so general reaction, it may be metal plus acid means they will give the salt plus hydrogen gas. So this hydrogen gas will gives the pop sound. Okay, so do now enadru heat madbekara test tube hatra tanvi antandre it will sounds like a pop. Okay, this hydrogen gas will gives the pop sound. So like that zinc also, so here also the zinc chloride plus hydrogen gas. So like this the metals react with the acids. So when the metals react with acids, so the salt and hydrogen gas will form. So there is a pop sound of hydrogen gases when they react with the metal. Okay, so like that copper, silver, gold will not violently, they will react with the this hydrochloric acid, but copper will react with the sulfuric acid, it will not react with the hydrochloric acid. ಓಕೆ, ಕೆಲವೊಂದು ಡೈಲ್ಯೂಟ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಆ್ಯಸಿಡ್ಗೆ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಕೆಲವೊಂದು ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಟೆಡ್ ಇದ್ದರೆ ಮಾತ್ರ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ದೇ ಆಲ್ ದ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ವೇರಿ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಒಂದೊಂದು ಮೆಟಲ್ ಒಂದೊಂದು ರೀತಿಯಾಗಿ ಅದ್ರ ಜೊತೆ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಜಿಂಕ್ ಮತ್ತು ಮೆಗ್ನೀಷಿಯಮ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಕ್ಲೋರಿಕ್ ಆ್ಯಸಿಡ್ ಜೊತೆ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆಯಿತು ಅಂದರೆ, ಬಟ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕಾಪರು ಎಷ್ಟು ಎಸ್ ಫೋರ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಸಲ್ಫ್ಯೂರಿಕ್ ಆ್ಯಸಿಡ್ ಜೊತೆ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿಬಿಟ್ಟು, ಸೊ ಕಾಪರ್ ಸಲ್ಫೇಟ್, ಕಾಪರ್ CuSO4 ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲೂ ಕೂಡ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಬಟ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಕ್ಲೋರಿಕ್ ಆ್ಯಸಿಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಲೈಕ್ ದೆನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ನಾನ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್? ಸೊ ದೇ ಡು ನಾಟ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ಡೈಲಿಟ್ ಆ್ಯಸಿಡ್ ಟು ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ದ ಸಾಲ್ಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸಸ್. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ನಾನ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ದ acids. Okay, so dilute acids jothe non metals so react agodilla. So then reaction with bases, bases, so some metal react with a base to form salt and hydrogen gases. So illu kuda nu ashte bases alli hege react agutte andre metal react with base gives salt and hydrogen gas, but here the pop sound will not produce. Okay, so for example, aluminium plus NaOH, so it gives rise to sodium aluminium aluminate LO2 plus H2. Sodium aluminate. Okay, like this. So here in the metals, the by forming the hydrogen gas, they will hurt the pop sound. But when the metals react with the bases, the hydrogen gas will not produce the pop sound, and here salt will produce. So sodium aluminate. When aluminium reacts with the sodium hydroxide, it is a base. So it, when it reacts with the base, it forms sodium aluminate. Aluminate. But in case of non-metals, they are not react with the bases. They are very complex reaction. So if they want to react with the bases, that is very very complex. All the metals will not react with the bases, but non-metals also the gas is produced. Reaction of non-metals with bases are very very complex. So here the reaction of metals and non-metals with bases. So these are the chemical properties of the metals and non-metals. Okay, so first we saw that the metals react with the oxygen. So metals matte non-metals hege react agutte anta nodidvi. So adralli magnesium matte copper na nodidvi, iron na nodidvi. So they will react with the oxygen and they will form the metal oxide. So by that we can say that they are in basic in nature. But when they will react with the water, so they will form the hydroxide. So when react with the water, the lot of heat is generated. Means some metals will not react with the water, so vigorously they will react. So some they will slowly react. Okay, so these non-metals are acidic in nature and metals are in basic in nature. Okay, so after that we saw that the reaction of metals and non-metals with the bases. So some metals will react with the bases, that is aluminium. So for example, I took this aluminium, so it will react with the bases and forms the sodium aluminate. But in the case of non-metals, all the non-metals will not react with the bases, but also that reaction is very complex. So these are the chemical properties of non-metals. Okay, then and another reaction they have given, displacement reaction. So what are the displacement reactions? Means, so the highly reactive substances, the highly reactive metal displaces the less reactive metal. So the displacement of more reactive metal by the, it displaces a less reactive metal from and form its solution. Okay, so idana navu displacement reaction anta karitivi. So for example, so illi nodabodu neevu iron plus copper sulfate. Okay, it gives FeSO4 plus copper. Here this copper sulfate is displaced by iron. Most means this is highly reactive than copper. Okay, so it will displaces the copper plus. Like this, the displacement will reaction will occurs. So in the same way, copper sulfate. When we copper sulfate will react with zinc, so this copper will. So this copper zinc will displaces the copper copper position. So here we can say that zinc is the, so here zinc takes the places of copper. So the highly reactive metals are displaced by the less reactive metals. So are called as displacement reaction. So our reaction alli illi metal one place anna innond tagondiruttala. So anta reaction na naavu displacement reaction anta karitivi. So nimma textbook alli one activity kottidare. So I have taken the 3-5 beakers, okay, they have containing the different solutions like copper sulfate, zinc sulfate, iron sulfate, like this. Okay, so by dipping, by adding them other solution, means if we are taking the copper sulfate solution in that test tube, we are adding the iron. So then what it will change is the color of the solution will change. So here we can say that this iron will displaces the copper place. Okay, this is means if iron is very highly reactive than copper, so here copper will comes out. So the reaction in the reaction the more reactive metal will displaces the less reactive metal and form a salt solution, are called as the displacement reactions. Okay, understood? So this type of reactions we will called as displacement reaction. So another one thing, so I told that properties of metals and non-metals, but some metals will shows the both the properties, means in between properties, like boron and silicon. So this boron will shows the both boron, silicon and antimony. So some other metals also will be there, they shows the intermediate characters, properties between the metals and non-metals. Okay, they will show us both properties, means not fully, but they will show us the intermediate between the metals and non-metals. For them we will call it as the metalloids. Okay, so the elements whose properties are intermediate between those of metals and non-metals and non-metals, okay, are called metalloids. Example, boron, silicon. So like this, some elements will shows the both intermediate properties of metals and non-metals. For them we will call it as metalloids. Okay, so these are the properties, physical properties and chemical properties of metals and non-metals. So then we will see the uses of metals and non-metals. So first we will see the metals uses. So where we are using the metals and non-metals. Firstly, the metals like iron, copper and aluminium are used to making the cooking utensils. Iron, copper and aluminium are used to make utensils. So they are very hard and they have high melting point, high boiling point. So that's why they are used for to making the utensils. So what are boilers? So then copper metal is used for electric wires. So now electric wires valgade now in wire nortivala, so it is made up of copper. So they are the good conductors of electricity and heat. That's why these copper metals are beaten, means they will shows the ductile property. Okay, so then iron is used to make nails andre mole matte screw ಸೊ ಇದರಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲ ನಾವು ಐರನನ್ನು ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದೆನ್ ಅನದರ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಮರ್ಕ್ಯೂರಿ. ಐ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ದಟ್. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಥರ್ಮೋಮೀಟರ್, ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಥರ್ಮೋಮೀಟರ್. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಲಿಕ್ವಿಡ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಥರ್ಮೋಮೀಟರ್. ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಯು ಆಲ್ ನೋ, ಸೊ ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸಿಲ್ವರ್ ಆರ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಟು ಮೇಕ್ ಜ್ಯುವೆಲರಿ. So these are the some uses of metals. So iron also present in our body. So hemoglobin content. So we want to raise the hemoglobin content, means we have to take the iron based food. So like this. So these are the, we are using the metals in our daily life. The iron, copper, aluminium are used to make the utensils, and this copper metals is for used for electric wires. Use it for making electric wires. Okay, so then iron is used to make the nails and screw. ಮೊಳೆ ಮತ್ತು ಏನು ನಾವು ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಲ್ಲ, ಸೊ ಅದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಐರನ್ ಇಂದ ಮಾಡಿರ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ಥರ್ಮೋಮೀಟರ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ರೆಡ್ ಕಲರ್ ಒಂದು ಲೈನಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ನಾವು ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ವಿಸಿಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ನೀವು ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು. ಸೊ ರೆಡ್ ಕಲರ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಒಂದು ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಅದ್ರ ಒಳಗಡೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮರ್ಕ್ಯೂರಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದೆನ್ ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸಿಲ್ವರ್. ಸೊ ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸಿಲ್ವರ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ಮೇಕಿಂಗ್ ದ ಜ್ಯುವೆಲರೀಸ್. ಸೊ ಬೈ ಸೀಯಿಂಗ್ ದೀಸ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ವೆರಿ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್, ಹಾರ್ಡ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ದ ಹೈ ಮೆಲ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್, ಬಾಯ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್. ಸೊ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದ ಶೈನಿ ಸರ್ಫೇಸಸ್, ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದ ಲಸ್ಟ್ರಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿ. ಸೊ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್, ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಯೂಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದೆನ್ ದ ಯೂಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ನಾನ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಹಾಗಾದರೆ ನಾನ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ನ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ? ನಾನ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್, ಸೊ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್. ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಈಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ಫ್ಯೂಯಲ್. ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಕೋಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪೆಟ್ರೋಲಿಯಂ ಲೆಸನ್ ವಿ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ದಟ್. ಸೊ ಕೋಲ್ ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ಕಂಟೈನ್ಸ್ ದ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಕಾಂಪೌಂಡ್. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ನಾನ್ ಮೆಟಲ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ನಾನ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ ಈಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ಫ್ಯೂಯಲ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಲಿಕ್ವಿಡ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್. ದೆನ್ ಫಾಸ್ಫರಸ್, ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹೈಲಿ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟಿವ್. ಐ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ದಟ್. ಸೊ ಫಾಸ್ಫರಸ್ ಆರ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ preparing the fertilizers. In preparing fertilizers means for plants we are applying the fertilizers. So those will contain the phosphorus and nitrogen also. Okay, sulfur also. Then third one is iodine. So iodine is used as an antiseptic to make an ointment. ಆ್ಯಂಟಿಸೆಪ್ಟಿಕ್ ಆಯಿಂಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ನಾವು ಏನು ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಲ್ಲ, ಸೊ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಅಯೋಡಿನ್ ಕಂಟೆಂಟು ಇದೆ. ಓಕೆ, ದೆನ್ ಕ್ಲೋರಿನ್ ಈಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಪ್ಯೂರಿಫಿಕೇಷನ್ ಪರ್ಪಸಸ್. ಸೊ ದೊಡ್ಡ ದೊಡ್ಡ ವಾಟರ್ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರೀಸಲ್ಲಿ ಸೊ ಈ ಕ್ಲೋರಿನನ್ನು ನಾವು ಕ್ಲೋರಿನ್ ಟ್ಯಾಬ್ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಯಾಕೆ? ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಪ್ಯೂರಿಫೈಸ್ ದ ವಾಟರ್. ಸೊ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಪ್ಯೂರಿಫಿಕೇಷನ್. So nitrogen also and oxygen. So we are using the oxygen gas for breathing. So namge plants and animals ge oxygen use aagta ide. So adhe rite nanu illi phosphorus helidnalla, so illi nitrogen kuda nu barutte, adhe rite sulfur kuda nu barutte. So these are all used for making the fertilizers. So now gobra hen aagtivala gidagalige, so aa fertilizers ella ಫಾಸ್ಫರಸ್, ನೈಟ್ರೋಜನ್ ಮತ್ತು ಸಲ್ಫರ್ ಕಂಟೆಂಟ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ನಾನ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಮೇಕಿಂಗ್ ದ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸರ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಎ ಫ್ಯೂಯಲ್. ವಿ ಆರ್ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ದ ನಾನ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಎ ಫ್ಯೂಯಲ್. ದೆನ್ ಅಯೋಡಿನ್. ಸೊ ಅಯೋಡಿನ್ ಈಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಎ ಆ್ಯಂಟಿಸೆಪ್ಟಿಕ್ ಆಯಿಂಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ನಾವಿಲ್ಲಿ ಆಯಿಂಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಥರ ಇದನ್ನ ಆಯಿಂಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಲ್ಲ, ಸೊ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಅಯೋಡಿನ್ ಕಂಟೆಂಟ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್ ಕ್ಲೋರಿನ್ ಈಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಪ್ಯೂರಿಫಿಕೇಷನ್. ಸೊ ತುಂಬ ಬಿಗ್ ಬಿಗ್ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರೀಸಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಕ್ಲೋರಿನ್ ಟ್ಯಾಬ್ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ಲೋರಿನ್ ಟ್ಯಾಬ್ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಪ್ಯೂರಿಫೈಸ್ ದ ವಾಟರ್. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಯೂಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನಾನ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್. Okay, so like this we are using the metals and non-metals. We came to know about the their physical properties and chemical properties, and which are the elements are come under metals and non-metals and their uses. Thank you.